you turn the dial, you put your foot down, and the Conti GT Speed transforms.
Hey crew, I've got the key to that Bentley Continental GT Speed. We are gonna take it for a drive, but first, let's check out how it looks on the inside and outside. The Speed model has been reintroduced for the 22 model year, and this one is clad in lots of gloss black for the meshed grille and the front air dam. Speed models get an extended carbon fiber front splitter. There's etched crystal for the projector LED headlight housings. The black line specification on this car adds a lip to those. This one is painted in St. James red. It's a non-metallic color. It's just fire. I love it on this car. From the side, this one has the optional set of 22-inch gloss black wheels wrapped in Pirelli P0 tires, 275 section front and 315 in the rear. Within those wheels, we can see 10 piston front calipers clamping on iron rotors. You can choose carbon ceramics as an option. The speed badge here tells you, you know what you're working with in terms of power. The 12-cylinder badge here in gloss black. The speed model gets extended side sills as an option in carbon fiber. There's gloss black for the window trim and a two-tone door handle. Stepping back to look at the profile, this is just a red hot rocket ship. And with those wheels, it's got this strong stance. Gentle slope to the roof line, off here to the back, where we find oval LED tail lights with a black lip around those. Carbon fiber lip spoiler, carbon fiber diffuser down low, and oval exhaust finishers around two pipes on each side. This car just belts. I've arrived. And you most certainly have when you open up that door and see the red matching interior. Let's check it out. Opening up and looking inside at this Hotspur red interior with linen accenting. There's red on the roof, red on the seats, red on the leather surrounds, and red on the carpeting. There is no escape, but some people may really love this. The doors are covered in leather. We have this nice diamond stitched pattern here with stitching on the inside in addition to the contrast. Suede accented there under the gloss carbon fiber. We have one-touch up-down windows, power adjusting, and power folding door mirrors. There's B on the aluminum door handles. Two-position memory for these front seats. Press this button to open up the trunk lid, where we find a generous 13 cubic feet of space, certainly enough room for one or two sets of golf clubs. There is a pass-through, but you cannot fold down those rear seats. Power close and lock feature on the trunk lid. This one has the upgraded Bang & Olufsen sound system, which is imprinted right here, and the aluminum speaker grates look and feel beautiful. Illuminated Bentley aluminum tread plate. Speed is just above that. These front seats are heated and ventilated with massage. Pull this tab and the seat will slide itself forward. The seat back is covered in leather. When it's finished with the conversion, we've got a pretty wide access point to get to the back seats. And the seat will automatically come back and sense where my knees are so that it won't crush me. But unfortunately, that means I can't speak to where it would be for me at 6 feet tall. Most likely, you're just gonna put smaller people back here because it's not just the knee room, the headroom is also an issue. My head is pressed against the roof. If I try to make it back to the headrest, if I slouch, if I had the knee room, then it would work. Just put small people back here, please. Leather all over this panel and this one. Slide this to find two cup holders, two USB ports, and a DC outlet. You have your own window controls and the headliner in Alcantara, and the Alcantara on the Speed headrest is so very, very nice. Even the tab has a knurled finish on it to get out. Yeah, getting out admittedly is not as easy as getting in for sure. I do wanna mention the panoramic glass roof, quite large for a coupe. Stepping inside, we have the soft close, taking care of the rest, and it brings out my seatbelt for me. So very nice of you. We'll put the vehicle in accessory mode here. so that the rotating display will show up, goes from carbon fiber to this 12.3-inch touchscreen infotainment system. It also has another showing of three dials. So on the left, we've got the outside air temperature. In the middle, we have our compass. And on the right, we've got a lap timer in a Bentley. Amazing. There's also a digital instrument cluster that is reconfigurable. And then there is a head-up display. Two tones of leather all over the dashboard. Feels amazing. Carbon fiber extends all the way over to the passenger side where there is a speed badge. We've got neural finishes for the volume knob, for the infotainment selection, and for the tuner. There's also an analog clock right here. These plungers are to open and close the air passageways. Lots of gloss black here that I don't love because it smudges, scratches, and collects dust, but at least it's real wood. The dampening on the cup holders is amazing. Two are right there. Under the padded armrest, which you can slide forward, we've got two USB ports and a DC outlet, of which the border is a knurled finish. I mean, this is just the attention to detail in this car. There's also a wireless smartphone charging pad there. Visibility is not as great out the back because the back comes up as the roof comes down, so there's narrow visibility. Thankfully, there's standard blind spot monitoring with rear cross traffic. This cabin is just incredible. It's a tactile delight. Every surface and material has some sensory feedback to it. The red might be too much for some. I want to know what you guys think. Is this just incredible or is it inundating? Either way, I'm excited. Let's take the Continental GT Speed for a drive. All right, let's fire it up. Seatbelt brought to me, screen flips out, and a tremendous rumble from the W12 on startup. And yet, barely more than a shiver from the chassis for all those cylinders coming on. It's insulation and build quality, my friends. So for our drive mode, let's begin in the Bentley or the everyday mode, and then we'll move into other modes later. Click down on the B and forward on the gear selector to bring up a high resolution backup camera. Got your bird's eye view off to the right, front facing view, wheel shots, panoramic front view, and a panoramic rear view. There are trajectory lines for us as well. We'll do our turning radius test later, but how about a world-famous horn test right now? Ooh. So proper. Turn signal sound. Refined. It's a refined turn signal note. Speaking of refined, let's talk about this powertrain. 6-liter twin turbocharged W12 in the Conti GT Speed. It makes 650 horsepower and 664 pound-feet of torque. That's the same torque output as the standard, if you can say standard, W12 motor, but it's 24 more horsepower. The W of the W12 refers to the orientation of those cylinders. So unlike a V12, where you've got six cylinders on either side, the W12 effectively pairs two V6s together. And you have to ask yourself, all right, so I'm paying $50,000 extra for the Speed model. Is that just for 24 horsepower? The answer is no. Because in addition to the extra power, you are getting an electronic limited slip rear differential and active anti-roll bars. The engine is mated to an 8-speed automatic gearbox and sends power to all four tires. It's an active all-wheel drive system. In Bentley mode, there's an incredible flow. Gentle tipping on the throttle elicits ample power. It's not touchy.
And the Conti GT just floats down the road. Maintaining speed is effortless. You can brush against the throttle pedal and pick up 5 or 10 mile per hour increments. Let's try out the turning radius. Oh, that is just insane! A vehicle of this size can pivot like that thanks to the rear wheel steering system. So the rear wheels at low speeds will turn in the opposite direction of the fronts, letting you maneuver incredibly well, giving you confidence in instances like that or in a parking lot. Beautiful day. The ride quality of this Conti GT Speed is sensational. You've got adaptive dampers and a 3-chamber air suspension system that doesn't so much stop you from feeling the undulations or roughness of the road. You can sense it's there, but it's so heavily suppressed that it never disturbs you. I'm so relaxed. But I think it's time now to see how quick the Conti GT Speed is to 60 with a real-world 0-60 test. For that, I've got my race box set up over here because I wasn't getting any reception on the front glass. And then we need to switch things up, go to sport drive mode, and hit the traction control button once. This is going to prime us up for launch control. Yes, in something this big and heavy, we've got launch control. We'll see what happens right about now. Whoa! 3.3 seconds to 60. And I say once again, that was a real world test. We faced a bit of an uphill there, and I hadn't worn the tires really. 3.3 seconds! It held the launch at 5,000 RPM. Unreal. You turn the dial, you put your foot down, and the Conti GT Speed transforms. Now, the only thing I missed from that back there was a boisterous exhaust note. What you get is a thump on the upshift and a deep bellow, but it doesn't have any raspy character that a V12 does. Even the V8 version of the Continental has more character to the soundtrack, but at least in exchange, the W12 Speed has helpings, huge helpings of power. We've gone into manual mode. Pull the paddle. Downshifts quickly. Oh! And upshifts much quicker. Almost as quick as this vehicle just accelerates. I mean, there are very, very few vehicles that will hurtle themselves up a hill like that with near the same velocity. Furthermore, the W12 is just buttery in the way it makes that power. The V8 is always like, you know, and like, and you feel every bit of it as it's performing. The W12 is just like, it's like you're just coasting on ice. You just move so quickly. Effortlessly. I mean, this car just makes effortless momentum. Okay, so you got a little bit of burble on the downshift. And I do know, if you throw this car in neutral and you just rev it out so you defeat the, you know, soft limiter that you get in park, it will crackle and pop. Just in motion, you have to kind of search for that a bit more. Considering the tweaks to the Conti GT Speed are about more than just the extra power, we do need to see how this vehicle handles itself in a corner. So we'll carry some speed into this curve. Clamp on those 10 pistons. Ooh, a little wiggle, but they do slow us down and then come in hot here. You can feel that rear wheel steering system now turning the rear tires in the same direction as the front, allowing us to just cut in. Meanwhile, the electronic limited slip rear differential got that power down. I was able to feed it in while we were losing some traction at the rear tires. Those pieces help the Conti GT Speed behave like a smaller, lighter vehicle. Excellent. In a straight line, in a curve, this vehicle outpaces how it looks. It looks just like a cruiser, but it's so much more than that. Let's go out of sport now into comfort. And turn traction back on fully. Engage the adaptive cruise control system. And lane keep assist. And just like that, the Conti GT Speed has transformed back into a blissful grand tour. The cabin insulation is just so thorough. You barely hear that wind noise. Just about zero tire and road noise. And that's impressive, given the contact patches and the skinny sidewalls. I would happily cover many, many miles behind the wheel of this car. I think it's time now for the miles per hour word of the day. And for the Conti GT Speed, that word would be bodacious, meaning excellent or admirable. Because I feel like just about everything this car does is excellent. It is so accomplished in the comforts, in the style, whether you like the red on red or not, in the details, in the power, in the smoothness. It just doesn't seem to have a fatal flaw. It is just the word I love to say, bodacious. Now let's move on to pricing and competition for this car. The starting figure for the Speed model is $280,000. That is, as I said, 50 grand more than the W12 model. The top speed I did not share with you yet is 208 miles per hour, and the fuel economy is 12 mpg, city 20 on the highway and 15 combined. Other grand touring, very expensive vehicles to consider. The Aston Martin DBS Superleggera, $319,000 for that one. It does make 715 horsepower from its V12 motor. It gets to 60 in a scant 3.3 seconds, and the top speed is 211 miles per hour. Then we can also consider the Ferrari 812 GTS. That vehicle is the most expensive at $404,000. It does make the most power at 789. The 0 to 60 is the quickest at 2.9 seconds, and the top speed ties the Superleggera at 211 miles per hour. So, the GT Speed, as equipped here, $350,000, but is the cheapest to start at 280. For that, you're getting power that isn't equivalent to its rivals and a 0 to 60 that's just a bit slower. But I'm going to say, if you favor the comfort factor and perhaps attention to detail, this is the winner for you. If money was no object for me, I would shell out the extra cash for the Ferrari 812 GTS, because That V12 soundtrack, the wail of that engine, is unreal. That, and added to the fact that it does not behave anywhere close to a GT car, it is such a finesse vehicle. It is so incredibly engaging to drive that it would be worth the extra money for me. But if you want to save your coins, this is really an excellent, excellent, bodacious automobile. However, I'll throw something else, another bee in your bonnet. You could consider the Conti GT with the V8 for just over $200,000. You're getting largely the same style, and I mean, you could spec it up however you want. You get a throatier exhaust note, a little more character, and a lighter weight vehicle, just something to consider. Would you guys go for the Ferrari, for the Aston Martin, or for the Bentley? Let me know in the comments, I'm very curious. And I hope you guys have enjoyed this POV drive review. If you did, please like, comment, and share the video. Subscribe to the channel. Hit that bell to get notified. And I'll see you next time.